us direction from above. We need a word from the Lord.
A city that is set on the hill that cannot be healed.
Right.
But we have to allow that light to shine
just
through us. I remember during July every year we had these big huge yard parties. And black
dogs.
But as soon as you turn the lights on, everybody in 3 mile area was there. They were drawn to that light.
Yeah.
That's the way we're supposed to be drawn.
Yeah.
It doesn't matter what kind of bug it was. They all came.
Come on now.
They all came because they saw a light. If we show the light, it doesn't matter what they're dealing with.
Yeah.
If we show them the light, they will come.
Yeah.
And they need to make sure that we're not in darkness.
Yeah.
If we're not in darkness, we need to find someone to have light ourselves and allow them to lead us.
Yeah.
A lot of us are walking in darkness thinking we're in light and stumbling all over the place.
Yeah.
But once we get in the light, we need to allow the light to shine through us, to reflect through us. The Bible also says that there was a man sent from God. His name was John. The same came for a witness, to bear witness to the light, that all men through him might believe. He was not that light. John understood something.
Yes, he did.
He was a witness to the light. John wasn't a light. We need to get to a place we understand. We came to bear witness. Jesus is the light. We're the witness to the light. And a lot of us are trying to witness before time. But he said, after you be endued with power from on high, you shall be witness of me. Once we get the Holy Ghost, have a boldness to go out. A lot of us won't go. Why? Because we're not bold enough. We're not bold enough. Why? Because we haven't spent enough time with God ourselves to develop a relationship that we can go in peace, knowing that no matter what goes on, that God is with us. But John knew that he wasn't the light, and he did what he came to do, bear witness. Our lives should be a witness.
Yeah.
If we want to be a witness to the light, what we need to do is the same thing Jesus said, if he be lifted up. Everything we do should be lifting up the name of God. Everything I say, every act I commit should lift up, should show Jesus, should point the way to someone, to Jesus. Now, Romans 8:29 said, those whom he did foreknow, he did also predestinate to be conformed into the image of his son. My second point, we should be replicating the life of Jesus. We should be living like Jesus did. Before we can live like Jesus lived, we have to understand, how did Jesus live? Who was Jesus? What did he do?
Right.
First of all, we understand that Jesus was a man of great compassion. Jesus would see a need, he would see pain, and he would do something to address it.
I know you're right.
When you read about the blind man, he went to Jesus and Jesus asked, what can I do for you? He said, we would like to receive our sight. The Bible says Jesus was moved with compassion. And he healed them. The man with leprosy told Jesus, said, if thou wilt, thou can make me whole. The Bible says Jesus was moved with compassion.
He was.
And he said, I will. Be thou made whole. Now these people came up. Some of us may be that way. These people came up and asked Jesus. And Jesus stepped in and did what they asked. But the Bible also tells me there was a time when Jesus was going and a funeral procession was going by. And he saw the woman crying. And the Bible said he was moved with compassion. He stopped the funeral, laid hands on the casket, and rose the dead boy up. Now she didn't ask. He saw the need. We should all have that spirit of discernment that we're able to see when there is a need. And we need to step forth and try to address that need. That's how Jesus lived. Not only was he a man of compassion, but he was a man of humility. Because the Bible teaches us that even though he was God himself, he made of himself no reputation. But he come down to earth in the form of a servant. And he humbled himself and became obedient. Now he left glory and laid his glory down. Come down here as a man to go through everything he did. He washed his disciples' feet. God was an example for us how we need to be humble. How we need to stop exalting ourselves and exalt Jesus. It doesn't matter, preacher, pastor, deacon, whatever the title. We're all called to be servants.
Right.
And we look at what those words mean. We know that all we are is servants.
Yes, Yeah.
And the Bible teaches us that he should, that want to be the greatest of you has to become the least.
Yeah.
So the higher up I want to be in God, the lower I got to be.
Yeah.
So see, God had a way to fix this thing. He wasn't going to let us get too big headed. If we want to do what God said, we got to come down.
Yeah.
He said, humble yourself before the mighty hand of God, and he will exalt you at due time. But if you exalt yourself, he said he will abase us. So we have to be walking in humility. Not only that, we have to be walking in obedience. Because God, Jesus was a man of obedience. The Bible says he humbled himself even unto death, the death of the cross. He became obedient by the things that he suffered. Everything he did was the Father's will. Anytime someone said anything, he let them know all he was doing was glorifying the Father.
Yeah.
Jesus walked in the ways that God would have him to be our example. How we ought to walk on this earth. How we ought to walk with compassion. How we ought to walk in obedience. How we ought to walk in humility so that we can reach others. I can't reach someone out there in on the lot if I go up with my chest all stuck out, thinking I'm better than they are, because I'm in a suit and they're on the lot. Because if I just look back a few years, I remember when I was on the lot, and people walked by. And I know how I feel when I feel like they were looking down on me. And one thing about life should teach us a lesson every day. We don't want to be treated. We don't want to treat others like we felt like we were trying when we were struggling out there. And a lot of us struggled out there. It was because of our ignorance. We didn't know. You know, the devil had us believing we having a good time. He trying to kill us all the time. But we thought we really, you know, we waited up all sick, thinking we had a good time there.
And can't eat for 2 days.
But yeah, we thought we had a good time. But we had to understand that if not by the grace of God, I'd still be under the
chair.
Someone had to bring the love of Jesus to me. Throw me off from under that tree. So I'm required to go back with that same love and throw someone else off from under that tree. Now, my last point is we need to be relaying the love of Jesus.
Yeah.
Now, before we can be found relaying the love of Jesus, we need to be our love of Jesus.
Yeah.
We need to be rehearsing our love for Jesus. Rehearsing is all we're doing is practice.
We practice,
you know, football team, they practice.
That's right.
That's how they get better.
Yeah.
We need to be rehearsing every day our love for Jesus.
Yeah.
Rehearsing my love for Jesus, not standing before the saints of God saying how much I love the Lord. And you notice I say before the saints of God, because we're not going to say it when we get out in the world.
Yeah, that's right.
I don't mind telling Brother Bill how much I love Jesus.
Right.
When I walk outside this door, I'm kind of keep that kind of quiet. I still love him, but I don't love him loud enough to say it real life. I still love him, but I ain't trying to tell everybody. I don't mind telling you because you love him too.
Right.
You know, me and you, we can agree on that.
Yeah.
But that man out there, he may not love the Lord.
Yeah.
I'm not keeping on the dock.
Yeah.
So, but anyway, we have to be fine rehearsing.
Right.
And how we rehearse the love of God. Jesus said in John 14, three different times, if you love me, you'll keep my commandments.
Yes, sir.
Amen. He went on in 21. He who has my commandments and doeth them, he it is that loveth me.
Yeah.
And then in 23, he said, if a man love me, he will keep my words.
Yeah.
He that loveth me not, keepeth not my saying.
That's right.
So if I love God, I don't have to go out or stand before you and tell you I love God.
Yeah.
The proof should be in the pudding.
Right. Yeah.
You should be able to see that I love God.
All right.
Everything I do, because I'm trying to do what God said. If he says, bless them that curse me, you shouldn't see me cursing back.
All right.
I stepped out of the love of God when you see me cursing back.
I know.
You know, if he says, love them that hate you, you should see me loving everyone.
That's right.
The Bible teaches us that we love without dissimulation. We don't pick and choose.
That's right.
We love everybody.
That's right.
Because that's what God has called us to do.
Right.
He said here that Jesus responds, they ask him one time, what is the greatest commandment? He said, love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, with all thy mind, with all thy strength.
Yeah.
He said, this is the first and greatest commandment.
Yeah.
Now,
the calm on the sea. But what we need is a special word that will burn within. And give us direction from above.